Hi everyone, I'm Shelly and you're watching There's No Place Like Home. I'm really excited for today's video because I'm getting back into the notebooking swing of things. So I'm going to share with you what our new approach to notebooking looks like this year. I think I mentioned in my curriculum video that I posted a couple weeks ago that we had taken a break from notebooking. It's something that we had been doing in our homeschool for quite a while. It was something that we were really having a lot of fun doing and something that for a time my children really enjoyed. But then after a while, we just started feeling like we needed something new. So we put all of our notebooking supplies on hiatus for about a year or two, I think, and we just decided to start implementing this year again. Now, I also mentioned in the curriculum video that we're going to be doing a notebooking loop of copy work, free writing journals, and interest-led notebooks. And that is very similar to what we did years ago. The one thing that is different, though, is our approach to the interest-led notebooks, because I really want my children to delve deeply into those interests that they have that they're going to be keeping their notebooks on. So when they came up with their topics for their notebooks, I told them that I wanted to do something that they would love to learn about or something that they always wanted to learn about but just never got around to doing it. And I also had them think about it overnight and I told them, don't tell me until tomorrow what it is that you want to notebook about, because this is something that I want to be a long-term project. I don't want it to be something that you get bored with after a week or two. So that is what they did. And so the different approach is that before, when we did our interest-led notebooks, they were just in our normal notebooking loop. So they would do interest-led notebooks probably once a week, sometimes once every other week. And this time, I really want my children to make their notebooks almost into a manual for the topic that they are doing, or basically writing their own skeleton of a book or a field guide. So this year, my children have to add something to their interest-led notebook every single day. And yeah, it's something that I didn't know at first how they would react to it, but I really explained to them that they are going to be doing something, or they can do something different in their notebook every day. A lot of times when people think of notebooks, they think, okay, well, it's just writing, writing, writing. And you know, it is. Notebooks are obviously about writing. It doesn't all have to be the same kind of writing though. It doesn't all have to be written narration. It doesn't all have to be essay style. It doesn't even all have to be lists of facts. You can do so many fun things in notebooks, such as illustrations, paintings, mapping, word search puzzles, comic strips. And yeah, I have shown this in a few of our other notebooking videos. I showed what my children's notebooks look like, and that's actually what I'm going to do with you today. I thought that I would just give you a glimpse of what my children's notebooks look like so far this year. There's not a whole lot added to it because we just started doing this maybe a week or two ago, but I wanted to give you some ideas if you wanted to do notebooking with your children. And I just wanted to, again, show you actually in real life that they don't all, not all pages have to look the same. They don't all have to be written narrations like so many people think has to be the case with notebooking. I do have to add, and it's probably late to say this, if you don't know what notebooking is, I have an entire playlist that you can go on and check out any of the types of notebooking that you would like to try. Today's video is more for those people who know what notebooking is and just need some fresh ideas, or who might want to try it because they never have before. So let's get started and I'll just show you what is in my children's notebooks so far. Okay, I'm hoping that this is going to turn out okay because my tripod is giving me a bit of a hard time and I wasn't able to set it up the way that I wanted to, but you can still see the notebooks and that's what the whole object of this was. So I have six children who are homeschooling this year, and again, I let them choose their own topics for their interest-led notebooks. So I have one who chose human anatomy, I have two children who chose animals. One chose insects, one chose nature, and one chose geography. I think that's all of them. So here's the human anatomy notebook. And again, this is just to give you an idea of what can go in a notebook. So here, what she did was she just put some vocabulary words having to do with the human body in here, and she decorated her notebooking pages. And I'll show you where I keep our notebooking pages, and I'll leave a link to where I get them from in case you wanted to use something like this in your homeschool. Over here, she had some more vocabulary words on this page. And again, here, it looks like she's got some vocabulary words here too. And more here. It looks to me like she's been putting, because we're also doing a unit study on the human body, so she might be including some of those. This is an illustration of the digestive system. And the reason that she chose this was because she does have ulcerative colitis, so she's very interested in the digestive system. So that's what she did there. Here she talked about the bones in your body, and here is a vertebrae, an illustration of a vertebrae, and she made up her own word search here and put some vocabulary words in the word search that she made. And this is just a diagram of the skeletal system, or the bones of the skeleton. And that's what she's done so far. And remember, we just started these like a week or two ago. So the next one is an animal notebook. Animal notebooks are always some of the favorites for my children. So here are some roadrunner facts that she shared. Then we have chipmunk facts, baby turtle facts. And I have to say that I mentioned that not all the notebooking pages have to look the same every day. But as you can see, some of my children choose to have the same format for their notebooking pages. So that's very important too. If your children decide that they want all of their notebooking pages to be basically the same thing, as long as they're on different subjects, they have not done anything wrong. That is completely fine. I just like to tell them that they can add a variety so that they don't get bored. Now, what I've been doing actually is on our whiteboard every day, I write a notebooking idea in case they want to try something new. So today's notebooking idea was to paint a picture for their notebooks. And a couple of my kids took me up on the offer to paint a picture for their notebooks, not all of them. But again, it's just to kind of shake things up a bit. Here she's got jellyfish facts and some more facts on jellyfish. And as you can see, some children like to color, some do not. It's their notebook. Here are some facts about bats, and I believe she said this is a bat here. The giant squid, and facts about the boom slang. So that's what we've got in this animal notebook. Now the nature notebook. This is my youngest child's. She has a rabbit here. And when they do illustrations, especially with the older children, I tell them that they have to do an illustration that at least shows that they learned something about the animals or about whatever topic it is that they're discussing. But especially with the older kids, usually if they're putting a picture, I want them to at least label it or to do some sort of diagram or a caption. But sometimes if they do a really detailed picture, I'm okay with just the picture. It really depends on the day. Here she talked about shrews and moles and flamingos. For your younger children, copy work can be done in these also. Even older kids sometimes, they can use these for copy work. These are prairie dog, oops, I'm like trying to look at my camera here. These are prairie dog burrows. Excuse me. We went to a nature center the other day, so these are just some of the brochures that she collected there. Oops, that's an empty one. On this one here, she entitled it Stuff I Did at Nature Center. So she talked about the beehive that we saw. It was an apiary, a video that we watched, and we had taken some bones there that we found to be identified. And here we just have another rabbit and another rabbit picture in its burrow. And here is the painting that she did today. Next we have insects. So again, some facts. Here's a water strider. She's got ladybugs here. And on this one, she did several insects. She has a drag and illustrations. So dragonfly, praying mantis, stink bug, and a horsefly. My 18-year-old daughter, she once had a pet stink bug, and she left for the day and came back and it was gone. She was so upset. She had named it Stinky. Anyway, that's my children. So bugs and insects. Here we have moths, stonefly nymphs, gall wasps, and here she did peppered moths. Here she drew a picture of a worker ant, and she drew larva on the border. This is a moon moth, and it looks like, oh, and she has a little note there. I love my mom and dad so much. Just saw that. Cute. Anyway, so here's another animal one, and remember I told you that a couple of the kids had done that. So here we have on crocodiles, and again, these are just a lot of more fact sheets or essay style. Rattlesnakes and funnel web. Here are some vocabulary words that he chose to share. We've got some more, just with some more animals, just with the facts. Trapdoor spiders, crocodile, Komodo dragon. And that looks like, I know that he did paint a picture today, but it was still drawing, so we didn't get to put it in here yet. And then lastly is the geography notebook. And I know that his are mainly the same because I know that he likes the same format. So he has some facts on Brazil, and there are some of the flags, Australia facts, Japan, another one on Japan. And as you can see, some kids decorate their pages, some kids do not. I am actually going to be going to the store for some stickers. I usually get them at Dollar Tree. And although it's not Dollar Tree anymore, we call it the $4 for $5 tree. But anyway, I didn't get to go there and get anything for them to decorate with, but I will. Here we have Romania. And then in the back pocket, he had some that we had run out of the plastic sheet protector. So he has England here and Romania. So again, his is mainly the same format. I think the flags might have been the only thing different. So as you can see, some of the children like to do something different all the time. Like my daughter with the word search and the vocabulary and the diagram. And then some prefer just to stick to more of same old, same old. And who knows, after a while he might change it up, but he's happy with that right now. So as for where we keep the notebooking pages, I printed up a bunch of them off of productivehomeschooling.com. And again, I'll leave the link for that in the description box. And I just put them in a binder. And so every day when my children are doing their notebook, they just flip through the binder and they choose the notebooking page that they want to use that day, depending on if they want a lot of lines or if they feel like drawing, or if they want to do a combination of an illustration and then some facts. It's all entirely up to them, but they know where it's at. I actually keep all of their notebooks plus this in, there's like a little tote that we have. So they're all together so that they know where to find everything. But I think that's all that I was going to share with you today. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet and would like to hear more of what I have to say, I would love if you would do that. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave one either here or over on Instagram. And if you like my work and would like to check out my Patreon page, I will leave a link in the description box for that as well. And I hope you have a great day.